Okay, good morning, folks. Welcome to the contest between the Reading D Squad hosting Drakett today. Your captains for today's game are going to be number 3, Braden Nowicki, and number 50, Jason Anderson. The Rockets come into this game still in search of their first win. Drakett's a pretty good squad from what I understand. They usually are, so this should be a pretty good contest. It's a pleasant day for football today. It's partly cloudy, probably somewhere in the low 60s. Be a great day as the Rockets will end up going on the road for a couple games after this game. So as we await the coin toss, it looks like Reading, I'm not sure if they won the toss or not, but I believe they will receive as the D's get ready to kick off here against Drakett. Okay, folks, here we go. We've got number 6, Giacomo Iapica, ready to kick off. Correction, Reading will be kicking off, not receiving, to open the game. He's getting his line ready, and we're underway. Good kick. It's going to be picked up by the return man. Rockets down there trying to stop him deep. And all right. It was a good tackle by a host of Reading special teams players there as the Rockets will come in and get ready for defense. Okay, first and 10. As Draco will get the ball, they're on their own 40-yard line. Rockets come out and look to be their 5-3 normal defensive set. Donahue was in there. Running back got a good pickup after that. Donahue was in the backfield. It looks like almost like a toss left, quarterback left. And the ball carrier is finally pushed out of bounds. The Drakett midshipmen, otherwise known as the middies, come up to the line of scrimmage. Here in a, looks like a, almost like a power eye set. Pitch pass to the wing back. Number 3, Nowicki's there. Finally chased down Anderson. Ultimately brought to the ground by Beckenhuis. Maybe a yard on the play. It's going to bring up 3rd and about 3 to go. Reading obviously is trying to hold them here. Drakett gets across midfield, they'll have a first down. There's the snap, I formation, giving to the running back. And he's brought down by a host of Reading defenders. Number 50, Anderson, was in there. Number 6, Iapica, was in there. Number 51, looks like Bonacci, was in there. But Drakett was able to get the first down on the play. So first and 10, they're inside Reading territory. Okay, let's see here what we've got coming out of the MIDI offense. I formation. The pitch pass, pitch right. And Centrella was almost there. Finally, he's tripped up after about a 2-yard game. Just gotta watch her. We got 2nd down, 8 yards to go. There's the pass. It's a screenplay, trying to catch the Rockets off guard, but Nowicki is not fooled. Great play by number 3, Braden Nowicki, as he gets back there and stops him at the line of scrimmage. The middies come out in almost like a pro formation. They've got wide receiver right, quarterback's in the shotgun. It's the handoff to the running back. He's trying to make something happen. The Rockets are there. He does have a little room outside. Wow, he's shaking and baking, and he's got some room on the outside. And he's going to go in for the touchdown. No flags on the play as the running back, it was about a 45-yard run as he scampers in to put the middies up by 6. All right, Drakett lines up for the extra attempt. see if the Rockets can hold him here. Going to try the pass, the screen play again. And Donahue is there. Initially was, looks like eight, Mascherelli. And they stop him. So great job by the Rockets to hold the to hold off the extra attempt. So it's going to be 6-0, Draken. All right, the Rockets are set to receive here. They've got back deep to return. It looks like number 7, Brendan Lindmark, and number 3, Braden Nowicki. Draken prepares to kick off. Get the ready on the right, ready on the left. And kick is underway. It's against the ground. It's a squibber. Finally jumped on by, smartly jumped on by number, looks like 41. Sean Crowley was down there to get his hands off it. As the Rockets will now go first and 10 from their own 44-yard line. Okay, first down. The Rockets are in their moose play formation. They've got Lindmark at quarterback. It's like a power left formation. The ball is to Lindmark. He's going to try to find some hole, some room up the gut. He gets a couple yards out of it. Following some excellent blocking by number 23, Michael Olson. Number, looks like 21, Sean Beckenhuis. Number 71, Colin Donahue. Number 10, Eamon Santrella. As they come back up to the line of scrimmage. Again, in their famous moose formation. Lindmark at quarterback, they're gonna give it to him. He's got some room, he's got a hole. And there is a flag on the play. Typically, you're gonna see a hold, but I didn't see a hold on this. So it's gonna be interesting to see what the call is. Maybe a, let's see which way the ref's going to go on this. It looks like it's going to be against Redding. I haven't seen the call yet. Yeah, they're going to back him up. And it's going to be, it is going to be a hold as they're going to back him up 10 yards. So unfortunate break there for the Rockets. Okay, second down, a little offensive shift. Oh, the ball is on the ground. I don't know if there's a fumble there or not. I think it was Mascherelli that was playing quarterback on that. I believe he was able to jump on the ball, at least cover it, to give the Rockets possession. And they do. So it's going to bring up a big third down, about third and 20 here for the Rockets. Okay. See if the Rockets can get some momentum going here. They've got, looks like Mascherelli got the ball. He's got some room outside. He's being chased. Great hole made by the offensive line to give Mascherelli some room along the outside. He takes back everything that holding penalty took from them, bringing up fourth down and 9 as I believe Coach Swanson is bringing in the punt team. We'll see here. They got Iapika back, he's your punter. So it looks like the Rockets are gonna punt this here on 4th and 9. As they get in formation, ready to kick it away. See if Iapika can get a nice boot out of this one. The snap, great kick. Excellent bounce. That's some good special teams. Let it roll right down there. Finally, they put their hands on it to convert the down. So, chains of possession, Draken ball. 40, Jack James comes in on the off, as a defensive line. First and 10 for Draken. Quarterback's looking to pass, but he's taken down. Great penetration by the Rocket defensive line. The host of them in there, including James, number 40, 71, Donahue. Look like 21 Beckenhuis, 50 Alexander, 51 Bonacci. That was an excellent job by the Rockets defense. Second down. The middies are in the shotgun. They like this formation with the four receiver set, two slots. Is the pass to the receiver. Oh, nice play by that receiver, but finally brought down by Centrella. Number 10 was there. He was assisted also, it looked like, by number 33, Learned on the corner. Great play. They weren't fooled by that. Third down. 12 yards to go. Slot back formation again. Quarterback's back. He's trying to go against Lindmark. Oh, boy. What a reception. Lindmark is in pursuit. He's trying to catch him, but the receiver is just too fast. And he's able to get in the end zone on what looked to be about a 60-yard, maybe a 65-yard pitch and catch. Excellent throw by the Middy quarterback as the Middies go up by 6, 12-0. Let's see if the Rockets can stop the extra attempt again as the Middies come out in an I formation this time. Two-receiver split. The give is to the fullback, and it looks like he's able to get over the line for the conversion as the Middies go up 13-0 at about maybe 2 minutes in the quarter. So we put our first player profile of the week. We'd like to look at number 80, Dylan Sweetser. Dylan is a fifth grader at the Barrows Elementary School. His favorite food is pizza. His favorite superhero is Optimus Prime of the Transformers, certainly one of mine. When he's not playing football, he enjoys playing Nerf gun battles. And when Dylan grows up, he wants to play in the NHL. That is number 80, Dylan Sweetser. So as the Middies kick off, the ball is kicked directly to number 41, Sean Crowley, who does an excellent job of jumping on the ball and giving the Rockets first down at midfield. Perfect. The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Number 5, Quinn Dolan, is in there to help out. See if they can move the ball. Looks like number 8, Mascherelli, is under center with an I formation. No, that's 10. That's Centrella, who gives it the ball to Mascherelli, who picks up a nice, probably about a nice 4-yard gain right up the gut to bring up second down. Rockets again, this time in what looks to be a power eye formation with Centrella under center. And they give it to Nowicki, number 3, who gets smothered at the line of scrimmage. Your center right now is number 70, Brady Swanson. He's doing a good job of getting it back to the quarterback as the Rockets go forward for maybe a yard on the play. Number 81, Zachary Galvin, in there to help out as well, bring up 3rd and 5. The Rockets are in a tight formation right now. They've got Nowicki split right, as looks like we've got some whistles on the field. Timeout. I believe timeout, Drake it. Less than chilly without that. As we start the second quarter, Rockets switch sides. Centrella under center. Looks like we had a little movement on the line, but not carried. Good hard run there by number 8, Mascherelli. Puts his head down, charges ahead for a few as he gets probably 2 or 3 yards on the play. Big fourth down. 2 yards to go for the Rockets. As we've got a timeout, Redding. All right, so we come back to the line of scrimmage. Rockets looking to move the chains here. They're in the tight formation. Centrella under center. He's got the tight eye. The handoff is given to number 8 again, Mascherelli. And it was, and it is enough for a first down. So great job in moving the chains by the Rocket offense as they bring the ball down to the Middy 39-yard line. And Yeah, first down. Going back to the tight formation. Stick with what's working, I say. As the center, Centrella is going to pitch it back out. Mascherelli's got some room on the side. He picks up about 5 yards on the gain. Great blocking out there by number 72, Sean Murphy. He was assisted by number 71, Donahue. Number 80, Dylan Sweetser. Second and five. Rockets have the momentum, looking to keep it. The give again is to Mascherelli. He's got a hole right up the middle. He's making a rush for it. And nice job. All right, touchdown. Wow, great job. Just what the Rockets needed. But a 35-yard rush on that play. The left side of the offensive line did a great job in giving Mascherelli all the room that he needed. As he saw a little bit of daylight, took advantage of it, and was able to get down into the end zone for six. Let's see if the Rockets can get here, get in here on the extra attempt. As Centrella calls the signals in from the sideline. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage again in their tight formation. This time they've got Mascherelli playing quarterback. He's in a moose play. He's got a little bit of room on the outside, and he gets across. Nice job. As the Rockets are slowly bringing it back here with about 8 minutes left in the second quarter. Rockets 7, Drakett 13. All right, Rockets are set to kick off. Number 6, Iapika. Ready to boot it deep. Drake is going with the two standard return men. And it's a good kick to the second level. It's bobbled around a little bit by Drake, but he's able to bounce on the ball, give the Rockets, give the Middies first down. What? Number 5, Quinn Dolan, and number 71, Colin Donahue, were instrumental in opening up that line for Mascherelli on that last play. Hopefully they can keep the momentum going and continue to put the ball in the end zone. So as the Rockets try to stop Drakett here, they're in their standard 5-3 set. The Middies hand the ball off to the fullback, trying to make some room. He's running ahead. Good hard running by the Drakett running back. He's finally brought down by the Rockets. There was a bunch of them over there. It looked like number 50, Jason Anderson. Number 51, Ryan Bonacci. Number 10, Centrella. All in there to make the stop. So second down as the Middies come off to the line of scrimmage. They need about 3 yards for the first. They're right at midfield. They're in their open receiver set. They've got a man in motion. It's a fake give. It's cutback give. Oh, nice move. The Giacomo Iapica is trying to chase him down. Number 3, Nowicki is there. But unfortunately, not in time as Drakett, on about a 50-yard run even, gets into the end zone. Hand off left side, made some nice cuts. It's going to put the rock, it's going to give Drakett another six. 19-7. You can hear the cheerleaders over there. Block that point, block that point. Is they're going to try to pass. Great play defensively by 21. Beckin Hughes, number 3, Nowicki, to stop the play. So with about 7 minutes left in the second quarter, we've got Drakett 19, Rockets 7. All right, so now, okay, the Rockets are in the kickoff return. Number 3, Nowicki. Number 7, Lindmark, back deep to return. Draker will kick off. It's a good kick. It's going to be to the second level. Becken Hughes picks it up, tries to make a couple yards. He gets out of there, brings the ball back to the Rocket 45-yard line where they'll take over first and 10. First down, 10 yards to go. The Rockets are at their own 45-yard line. They're in the moose play formation. The give us number 8, Marciarelli, who breaks a nice tackle. He's got some room along the outside, and he's finally pushed out of bounds after the first down. Nice room that the line gave him on the right side to open it up and give him a first down. Looks like he had 41, Sean Crowley there. 22, Jordan Whitmer was in there. 42, Vedant Narayan was in there. So great job by the offensive line to allow Marciarelli to pick up the first down. As they continue to move the ball, they're going back to this moose formation. And it is back to Marciarelli, and he's hit immediately behind the line of scrimmage. As I don't know what happened on that play, but that defender got in there and put a helmet on Marciarelli. Hopefully he's okay. Looks like he's going to be all right. It's going to bring up second down and about 13. Rockets come back out in the moose formation. They've got the three blocking backs to the left as they give it to Becken Hughes, who tries to cut up and get a few as he's finally tackled after about a 3-yard gain for third down, bringing it third down. All right, Rockets come back out in what appears to be a little confusion on the line of scrimmage there as they try to get everything settled out. And it looks like they will go back to their moose formation. The ball is snapped. It's given directly to Becken Hughes. He's got a little bit of a seam on the outside, but it's closed quickly by Drakid. As it's going to bring up fourth down and about 8 yards to go, 9 yards to go for the first down. So I got a feeling Coach Swanson here is going to continue to go. They have some momentum. They just need to get down to about the 28-yard line, keep this momentum and keep this drive alive. As the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage, number 70, Brady Swanson is going to take over. Is at center. They are going back to the moose formation. They like the play. It's been working. So let's see if it'll get him enough for the first. He's got some room. He made a nice little cut to come up the middle. But it's unfortunately going to fall short of the first down as Drakett will take over at their own 33-yard line.
Cameron.
All right, Middies take over. First down. The Rocket defense is going to try to obviously stop him here. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica is trying to chase him down. Nowicki gets a hand on him. Running back is still going. Finally brought down. But it looked like number 80, Dylan Sweetser, number 21, Aiden Becken Hughes. The midshipmen were able to move the chains for a first down.
Shit.
All right, we've got first down. The Drakett midshipmen, they give the ball, but number 71, Colin Donahue's back there to make the play, along with number 23, Michael Olson. Great play by the Rockets to stop the defender for about a yard gain. All right, Rockets come out. Trying to stop him here on second down and 9. Middies are in their standard slot receiver set. They give the ball to the running back. He's got a little bit of room. Not enough for the first down, though. Third down, 32. All right, our second player profile of the game is going to bring up, we're going to look at number 32, Michael Bartolini. Michael Bartolini is not playing today as he has an injury. But Michael Bartolini goes to the Birch Meadow Elementary School. His favorite food is pasta. And his favorite hobby when he's not playing football is to play baseball. And when Michael Bartolini grows up, he wants to play in the major leagues as a baseball player. So that's number 32, Michael Bartolini, as the coaches will huddle up here as during timeout. Third down, and looks like we may have another timeout here as there could be a little bit of confusion in the personnel for the Rockets. Yep, looks like we've got a timeout ready. All right, now I'd like to acknowledge the cheerleaders again, as we do every game, getting the fans in the stands riled up here. These girls always do a great job, as they're doing a great job right now. That's your Reading Rocket D Squad cheerleaders. Okay, looks like we're back in play now. Third down, 4 yards to go for Drakid. We got a man in motion. The give is to the man in motion. He's trying to find some daylight on the side. He's got a little bit. He's being chased by 81. Zachary Galvin, he's finally brought down well into Rocket territory by, looks like Mascherelli was there to stop him, as well as Carter Leonard, number 3. But we have a flag on the play, folks. We have a holding against Drakid. Wow, I didn't see that one until just now. So a holding against Drakid, which is going to bring the middies back 10 yards. That's a big break for the Rockets, as they'd still be third down, but about third this time, and about 13 to go as the refs keep the clocks going. See if these Rocket interior defensive linemen can stop them here. Going back to the slot receiver set for Drake. Quarterback in the shotgun, takes the snap. He's going to drop back to pass. And Nowicki was there, but the ball just got into the receiver's hands. So a nice play by Drake. It gives him a first down. And they're inside of Reading territory, right about at the 35-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go for Drake. Quarterback is in the shotgun again. He gives the ball. No, it's a little quick screen pass, trying to catch the Rockets off guard. And the running back is still running. There's some good physical contact down there on the field. And the Reading, it's going to be timeout Drake it this time after about an 8-yard game. So after the time, all right. Drake it coaches get everything squared away, get the players back on the field. Quarterback in the shotgun. He's got the running back to his right side. He's going to try the quick pass again. This time it's a reverse. Almost like a hook and ladder type play. Very tricky. I don't see any flags on the play. That is a touchdown for the middies after about a 28-yard play, as the Rockets, I do believe, were a little fooled on that play. I haven't seen anything like that. So Drake it, we'll get the ball as they go for the extra attempt. All right, the middies come up to the line of scrimmage. Trying for the extra attempt. Let's get that block, that kick, block that point going. As they pass, ball's really good pass by the Drake it quarterback as it hit the receiver. It was a bullet though. Tough to catch at this level. Drops incomplete as the score, with about a minute or so left at halftime, the Drakid middies are 25, Rockets are 7. Okay, folks, as we start the second half here, Redding will get the ball. He got back deep. Oh, the ball's on the ground. And let's see, it looks like Mascherelli. Yep, number 8 Mascherelli was able to fall on the ball and keep it. So the Rockets will get the ball first down. 10 yards to go, and they are at their own about 47-yard line. So as we start the second half, we've got a score of Drake at 25, Rockets 7. See if the Rockets can come out here and make this second half a whole new game. They start the ball, good long drive, obviously down to the end zone would be ideal here to create some momentum. So the Rockets are going to come back out. What they have is their, looks like moose formation. The ball is given to number 8. I believe it was Mascherelli, who gets maybe a yard on the play. Second down. Okay. Rockets come to the line of scrimmage. Looks like a moose formation left. Ball is given to Mascherelli, who is met immediately behind the line of scrimmage. Maybe gets, he did a nice job of moving the ball ahead for about a yard, maybe 2 yards out of the play as they're right at midfield. Rockets come out again, looking to keep this momentum alive. The ball is given to Mascherelli, but he's wrapped up right at the line of scrimmage by the defender for Drakid. They lost about a yard on the play, and now they're going to come out with a, looks like they're going to punt the ball here. So Coach Swanson is going to try to kick the deep ball deep. IAPIC has been doing a really good job of punting this game, so hopefully he can get that kick again here. Let's find out. Ball snapped, it's bobbled a little bit. He has some room to kick it, and he's gonna kick it. And again, a great kick with an excellent bounce. Bring the ball right down to about the 25-yard line. So the middies will take over, first and 10. Okay, first and 10 as the middies take over. They're deep inside their own territory at the 25-yard line. Rockets back to their 5-3 set. Quarterback, it's a quick little pass to the, we've got a holding on the play. Great job by number 33, Carter Learned, to come in there, but there is going to be a holding against Drakid. That's the tricky thing about that play right there. You got to have that receiver come out and hold that cornerback for a little bit to make that play effective. And a lot of times you can find that the receiver will end up holding, as Learned did a great job to get off that defender. So it'll back the middies up 10 yards. To about the 15-yard line. The midshipmen are back in the slot receiver set. They're gonna try, oh, they've got a man deep. They've got a, what an excellent catch by the receiver for Drakid. Wow, a one-handed, looks like an Odell Beckham Jr. catch right there. So, you know, that was a great play. Bringing up first down for Middy. For the middies. All right, after the fantastic first down reception by Drakid, they come to the line of scrimmage, first and 10. Back in the slot receiver set, quarterback is going back to pass again, and he's got, I tell you, this quarterback for Drakid is right on the money. Number 12, you know, he must, like most of the kids around here, be a big fan of Tom Brady. He's throwing like him today too, that's for sure. So we've got second down, 10 yards to go. Middies come up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback in the I formation. He's going to drop back. He's looking to go deep here. And Nowicki almost makes a great play. But once again, the middies are able to complete the reception, about a 20-yard reception, to bring up first down. Middies come up to the line of scrimmage. quarterback again in the shotgun. He's going to try the quick pass out to the slot back, who's got some room along the end zone. Excuse me, along the sideline. Finally wrapped down by number three, Braden Nowicki. Stays in bounds, keep the lines, to keep the clock going. Hey, these Drake midshipmen, about every single time they touch the ball, it's about 7 or 8 yards. Again, quarterback in the shotgun, slot formation. He's going to try to go deep on this one, and he's got a man deep as Drakett gets in the end zone for another 6, making the score 31-7. Midshipman will line up for the extra point. Quarterback's got two backs to his side. He's going to hand it off to the fullback. He's going to try to charge up the line. Pile is still moving, but no good. As the big front there for the Rockets stops him. And Rockets will go into kick return again with about 5 minutes left in the third quarter. At the cheerleaders once again. They're doing a good job of getting the girls up. Excellent job. It will kick off to Rockets. We've got number 7 Lindmark, number 3 Nowicki back deep. And there's the kick. It's a good kick this time. It's picked up by number 7 Lindmark as he's looking for some room to get up the field. And he brings it back to about the 41-yard line where they'll take over first and 10. All right, the Rockets come out here with a little bit of a different formation this time. It's an I formation. They've got the wide receiver right. They've got Centrella in the backfield. The give is to number 8, Musciarelli. He gets maybe a yard on the play as the Drakett defender was able to get in there and stop him. So, second down. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer, comes into the game to see if they can help move this ball along. Back in the I formation with a slot left this time. The pitch is to... let's see who the ball carrier was on that. It was Musciarelli again, who gets about a yard, maybe 2 on the carry to bring up third down and about probably 77 yards to go here for the first down. The big linemen come to the line of scrimmage. This time they've got wide receiver right with Beckenhughes, number 21 and 8, Musciarelli. Centrella at the quarterback. And they are going to try to pass it. And nice attempt as it falls incomplete just over the intended target on the play was Beckenhughes. But the ball goes incomplete, bringing up fourth down. Got a big fourth down here. Centrella's in the slot. They're going to try to pass it again. He's being chased. He's going to try to, he does, he keeps the ball. But he's unfortunately tackled out of bounds as the Drakett midshipmen will take over first and 10 inside the Rockets' territory at about the 47-yard line. All right, at the start of the fourth quarter, Drakett will take over first and 10. They're inside Rocket territory at the 47-yard line. This time they're in an I formation. Looks like they're changing up plays a little bit, mixing in other people. Ball carrier moves the ball forward for about 5 yards. The middies come back to the line of scrimmage, sticking with the I formation. Rockets in a tight 5-3. It's the power eye to the this time to the fullback. Gets about a yard on the play. Third down as the Rockets want to try to hold him here. I formation, the give is to the fullback for Drakett. He pounds ahead for a couple yards. The pile is still moving, and I think that second effort was enough to get him. Yeah, it was. It was enough to get him the first down as they moved the chain. So a great, really a nice run by the Drakett running back as he kept the feet chugging and was able to get enough for the first down. First down. Handoff is to the tailback, puts his head down, chugs ahead for maybe about a yard on the play. The Rocket interior lineman did a great job there of stopping him. Number 22, Jordan Whitman. Number 40, Jack Janes, excuse me. Number 50, Jason Anderson. Number 71, Colin Donahue, all there to make the stops. Second down. They're just sticking with the I formation. Oh boy, the running back bursts through the hole, kept his feet, and gets a first down. He's got enough to move the chains. First and 10 for Drakett. All right, after the chain gang has the stakes set, it's first down for Drakett as the running back is shifting and moving his feet, and he brings it down close to another first down. I believe it's going to be about second and 9 as they are inside the red zone at the Rocket 14 yard line. Drake comes up to the line of scrimmage, sticking with the I formation. Gives to the fullback, but he's stopped. Whole host of Reading defenders there. 71 Donahue I can see in there. 21 Beckenhues. See who else peels up off the ground here. And we have an injury timeout. And for our last player profile of the game, we'd like to look at number 23, Michael Olson. Michael goes to the Birch Meadow Elementary School. His favorite food is steak. His favorite superhero is Wolverine. And when he's not playing football, he likes to play baseball. And when he's all grown up, he wants to play either professional baseball in the major leagues or in the NFL as a football player. So that's number 23, Michael Olson. Okay, after the timeout, injury timeout, Drakett will, excuse me, get the ball, third down, 1 yard to go. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. We've got a flag on the play. Looks like we could have a hold. He's finally met by Mascherelli, Whitmer, Beckenhues, Donahue, as... Looks like we've got another Rocket down on the field, and I believe we're going to have a hold on the play as Drakett will go backwards 10 yards. We've got an injury on the field. Looks like we've got I believe that's the game, folks. Yeah, that looks like it's going to be the end of the game. So, not sure what happened there. It seemed like there was about 4 minutes left in the game. I don't know if the clock just sped up or really what happened on that play. That was interesting. But anyways, as we end here at Allingsworth Field. The Rockets lose a tough one today against a very, very good Draken team. You got to give them a lot of credit. I mean, they tried hard, but this Draken team is quite good. I imagine they're going to go pretty far this year. So the Rockets have nothing to be upset about. They hold their head high as they look forward to take on Chelmsford next week in Chelmsford, where we will see you then.